first stop on my visit to Kenya's Rift Valley was Lake Naivasha, a large freshwater lake 2 hours northwest of Nairobi. After a number of different attempts, and finally a bit of luck, I had succeeded in my aim to film hippos out of the water, as a pair came ashore early one evening. They weren't bothered at all by my presence, and eventually slipped back into the lake after feeding on some water hyacinth. That night, they came ashore once again, this time near my campsite. In the low light provided by a perimeter lamp, I filmed one grazing quietly. They weren't the only animals active in the dark. With unfamiliar noises, it felt like a new world had come alive. I was extremely lucky not to put my foot right on top of this trail of soldier ants as I walked along the path on the way to my tent. I noticed that at night, the column had guards only along the sides, but during the daytime, the guards formed a network of bodies into a complete tunnel for the workers to run through. This roof of ants protected the workers from attack. I was astonished at the organisation of a group of such tiny creatures. While a bite from a single ant is painful, but rather harmless, the sheer number of ants that attack an intruder can be overwhelming. I encountered a number of birds of prey around the lake, but my favourites by far were the African fish eagles. Luckily, my campsite appeared to be right in the middle of a pair's territory, and they could often be seen in the treetops together, or out catching fish. When they were apart, they would call to one another, a beautiful, fluty cry that didn't at all emulate the ruthlessness of these hunters. Was it perhaps a longing call for the other bird to return? Once again, it was the smaller birds which had the most attractive plumages. This Hoeglin's bush robin initially had my adrenaline racing, eager as I was to catch such a splendid species on camera. However, it proceeded to hop closer and closer until I had difficulty keeping up with its bounding movements with the camera. I later noticed something sticking out of the bin. Another snake? Far from it. A vervet monkey, one of the smaller primates and quite common in East Africa. Monkeys are intelligent and, amongst other things, opportunists. They know to look in waste bins for the food that humans have thrown away, and rather than being pushed out by an ever-expanding population of humans, they have adapted and learnt to live with them. They appeared so human-like themselves, and I was amused watching them. Having a morning stretch, for example. A troop of them made their way through our campsite, some carrying very young infants. They were very inquisitive, and not at all afraid of me. In fact, I found it rather frustrating that they paid me so little attention, because it meant they hardly ever looked into the camera. Nope, not interested. They were soon on their way again, as was I. Leaving behind Lake Naivasha, I headed south through the Rift Valley to an isolated mountain. It doesn't look nearly as high as 2,776 metres, but the whole region is so high up that even on the valley floor, you are over 2 kilometres above sea level. The path was a steep one, and the black rocks betrayed its volcanic history.
It's Thursday the 15th of January, and I'm climbing Mount Longonot in a national park here. It's been a really tough climb so far. It's not too far, it's only 3.1 kilometers from the gate to the crater rim, but it's very steep, and carrying all the camera and equipment is pretty tough. But apparently the views from the top are spectacular. They're already amazing, just halfway up. So I'm looking forward to getting to the top.
Since its last eruption over 150 years ago, An entire forest ecosystem has developed on the fertile land at the bottom of the crater. What creatures could be living down there? The steep sides to the crater mean that larger mammals would find it impossible to get in or out, but there were certainly some birds living here. White-necked ravens were impressive enough on the ground, but when they took to the air, they were as graceful as if they were, well, dancing. From the highest point, the views over the crater and beyond were stunning. There was an entry point into the heart of the mountain, but I wasn't here for that. Maybe another time. To the east, the Rift Valley was bordered by the Aberdare mountain range, and to the north, I could see the vast greenhouses around the shores of Lake Naivasha. Trekking back down the mountain, my attention was caught by something much smaller. These ants had found a home in the acacia bushes, and they in turn protected the bushes from grazing damage. An amazing mutual relationship between plant and animal. Near the foot of the mountain, I spotted a couple of buffalo feeding in a clearing. It was only on closer inspection that I noticed I'd caught three zebra on camera too. They were surprisingly well hidden on the slope in the background. However, I knew I would soon get much closer views of these large mammals. It was time to go right into the heart of the bush myself and get eye to eye with some big animals once again.